I words, the last few words, are really ringing in my ears and my heart this morning. For I am yours and you are mine. I had something prepared that I wanted to say today, but I'm not going to say that. I feel like this morning God is calling out to us to trust Him. Put our faith in Him when it feels like maybe we have reason not to. Or I think it's tempting when we're struggling, or when things are not going according to plan, or not going the way we were hoping, or and things aren't turning out the way we wanted, or there's just simply conflict or problems or struggle or tragedy coming our way. It's tempting to want to fix those things. It's tempting to want to somehow, through our own capability and our own volition, overcome them. But the truth is, we really need to rely on God in those times. We need to lean on Him and allow His methods and His ways to be the solution. That can be really hard, especially as a guy, I know, personally. It can be difficult to lean on the Lord rather than trying to come up with a way to remedy the situation or make it make sense or whatever it might be. I think it's one of the hardest things for us to do is to trust God when things aren't going well. Trust God when things aren't what we're hoping for. It can be difficult to humble ourselves and put Him first, to set aside our wants and our desires focus on Him and trust Him that He has a plan and He knows what He's doing. And that whatever situation we might be going through, that God is in control of those things. And His grace is sufficient for us and that we can make it through those difficult times. So when I think about how do I do that? How do I give over control to the Lord? How do I let Him guide me rather than me trying to focus or guide Him in some way? Communion oftentimes is my answer to that. It's my how. Probably the most common thing I ever say up here about communion is that we not take this experience for granted. That we not let this just become is the thing that we do on Sunday morning. And I say that all the time. I'm mostly talking to myself. I want to not let this become just a procedure. I want communion to be the thing that reminds me of what Christ did for me. Because when I'm reminded of what Christ did for me, it reminds me that He is in control, that He is capable, that there's nothing that He would not do on my behalf. And that although His methods and His solutions and the way that He leads us and guides us aren't always the ways that I would do it. His ways are better than mine. His ways are right. And when I'm having trouble trusting Him or having confidence that He's going to take me through a difficult period, communion always helps me remember that He will do that. That He will be there for me. That I can trust Him. His mercy is unending and unfailing. His grace is sufficient. His love is everlasting. So this morning, I'm hoping that as we break bread together, as we take communion together, that we'll take some time to get humble before the Lord, set our desire for control aside, and that we would put Him first, and we would be reminded through this experience how much that He loves us, how much that He cares for us, and how far that He's willing to go on our behalf. On the night He was betrayed, He took bread, He broke it, He gave thanks to the Father, said, "This is my body broken for you, take and eat in remembrance of me." Supper was ended, He took the cup, He said, "This is the cup of the new covenant, my blood poured out for the forgiveness of your sins. Take and drink in remembrance of me." Heavenly Father, Lord, we are grateful for the soccer.